Mr. President, pleasure to have you on again.
Thank you so much.
Everyone is wondering about the counteroffensive. There was a sense that it was slower than expected. Now there is some hope that it is speeding up. Can you give us a sense from your perspective, how is it going?
It depends on many directions, on many cases and issues, how to speed up counteroffensive. But remember that we need the result. The result we have to get our land, we have to get to deoccupy the land. And it's also not about the land, it's about the people, because the frozen war is not the peace. Putin, he want to take all our country, to destroy all our families, houses, because if he understands why he destroyed, he understands that Ukraine will never go back, go away from our land, will never do it. That's why he has to kill us. He want to do it. That's why when we speak about the counteroffensive, it depends on many cases. Of course, we gave a lot of time for Russians. We gave a lot of time to prepare to mine.
To put
the mines on the fields and on the big territory. And so you see the three defending lines.
And that's because you were waiting for Western
For the weapon.
Weapons.
That's why I said, yeah. That's why that what I said, it depends on many issues. We waited too long, it's true. No, I'm thankful to partners, to United States, EU, other partners. I'm thankful very much, President Biden and to Congress. But we have to understand, we waited too long, they put mines. Then when we been ready from the point of view of our partners, because the decision to give us, for example, Bradley or another kind of weapon, the decision, it doesn't mean the result.
You don't get them immediately.
Of course you don't. Of course you don't. So something still on the way. Till now, when we are sitting and speaking about it, when counteroffensive, when a lot of different people say that it's too slow, but it's still on the way.
Do you feel as though when you go to Europe and the United States and you make these demands, you have these lists of weapons, do they listen to you?
First of all, what we need, long-distance weapon systems, long-distance artillery, rounds, systems, etc. Everybody speaks about the ATACMS. It's very important. Everybody speaks about the jets, for example, in the sky. It's very important. We have the decision. Let's start from the ATACMS. I hope, and I will speak with President Biden. For me, it's very important his thoughts and his support in it. I think he can change this page and this war. Once he did it with the HIMARS. It was very important with HIMARS. So it's about ATACMS. I will speak with the President Biden again. It's not the first dialogue. So we are moving. I hope we'll get it in autumn. For us, it's very important not to do the pause in this counteroffensive, and I need it very much. The second, when we speak about the jets, and I said before the counteroffensive with our partners that they have to know and to recognize that we don't control the sky. How to control or even to compare with the power of Russia in the sky? All of us want to have success and happy end. First of all, it's not a movie, it's not one hour and a half. It's about counteroffensive. It's not the movie with the happy end. We will not have happy end. We lost a lot of people. No happy end. That we have to recognize it. A victory, that's only one thing that can bring the occupation of our land. It means not to give possibility for Russia to attack other countries, Baltic, Poland, and then to bring all of us back, you know, by this aggression back to USSR. We don't want that's only position for this. Victory is not happiness. Victory is only one possibility to ally. And people in the West have to recognize it. Not our not our values, common values, not our war, common war. We pay the highest price, it's true. And I don't want to repeat these words. Everybody knows these words, but they can not only know. People in the West have to feel it. And you can choose. Feel it when your family's under attacks. You really want it? You really want to try it? I can't recommend it.
There are people who say there has to be some kind of negotiation. We can't go on like this. The president of Brazil, Lula, has said Ukraine needs to get out of a Cold War mentality and compromise and even understand that some territory will have to be given to Russia. I'm paraphrasing, but I think that's roughly speaking the kind of view. And you know, you've heard this. What do you say to people like President Lula?
First of all, he has his own position, it's his rights. I'm okay with people are free and they can give their position worldwide. But I think he doesn't understand that the position of Putin not to stop the war, that is the answer. His position to continue. His position to continue the war. His position is to divide the Europe. His position is not to have strong European continent. One prime minister told me, and it's true, and she's one of our friends, she said that, you know, why I'm supporting? My question was, why you support us? And she said, people who understood Putin have to choose only you support Ukraine or you support Russia. There is no other variance, really.
There's no space in between.
No space between. It's true. The question of the time. The question of the time, when you will recognize it and when you will understand it. It means that if Lula don't support us, he will. If he doesn't support us, he will support Russia. Even he doesn't want. That's why. Lula, maybe he said, I don't know what did he mean, but he said it about that we have to stop the war and we have to find compromise always with the people who are ready to compromise, who are compromistic to other issues. Did you see any compromises from Putin in other issues? Did you see? Did somebody see? With Chechnya, with Georgia, with Moldova, he occupied all these countries. He divided all these nations.
Do you think Putin is stronger today or weaker after Prigozhin, after everything?
I think he is, my thoughts, that is the real face of him. That is the real face. There are the answers. How he see his life, the life of people, how he see what will be tomorrow, how he control. And you will find in this, in one case with Prigozhin, you can find, and even Lula, he can also find for himself and such partners, they can find all the answers.
Just see the way he handled Prigozhin.
Yes, that is the answer. How Putin control everything. He control only people's minds, but he doesn't control what's going on in the country. He doesn't control. Then when he understood that a big part of society supports Prigozhin, what he did, he killed him. But before he killed, he gave him promises. The territory of Belarus gave him new locations, the Africa issues and businesses, a lot of different things.
So he lied to Prigozhin. Yeah.
Yes, of course. And that is the answer. When you want to have compromises or dialogue with somebody, you can't do it with a liar.
Back at home, you are fighting corruption. You fired the defense minister. You've put a new defense minister in place. This is something, as you know, people in the West worry a lot about. There's a lot of money going to Ukraine. Do you think you have been able to stop this and put in place a system that will stop it?
First of all, we have to understand that everything which today belongs to justice in Ukraine, justice for today for people is very sensitive. And it's because of the war, because our fighting for these values, we can't give possibility to live that way which we lived during some years before, and etc., dozens of years. It doesn't matter now how many years ago it was. It means how it will be after the war and after the victory. Another country, another people, another generation, another way. So that's why.
But are you able to make the changes to get to
course.
That new way?
No. I have no another way. Here I don't have alternative, and I don't want. We don't want to have any compromises with any, not only corrupted things or people, even thoughts about it, you know?
But look, there are a lot of people who say there has been a lot of corruption in this first year, and that that's why you are firing.
First of all, you have to know, all these cases are not with the help, are not connecting that, не пов'язано, as not connected with the help of our partners. So it's not about the weapon of our partners, or money for the weapon, or money for the budget to give pensions, social support, etc. It's another cases. It's not about the partners.
These are Ukrainian funds.
These are Ukrainian cases. But anyway, yes, but anyway, it doesn't matter for me. Now, we will fight and will and win in this war. But again, I'm underlining it's not the money of our partners. Also, it's important to know.
Finally, 600 days of war for you, nonstop work. How are you holding up, and do you get depressed? How are you managing?
No. I'm okay. So I can live with it. And Sometimes I don't have a lot of time, but sometimes I'm looking on my children. Yes, they are in Ukraine. They are very Ukrainian, and I'm happy that they are here. I mean that this generation will make Ukraine great, because they are very strong with all the positions, with all the values. With all, you know, they're very free, and I'm so happy. Then I'm looking to the mirror. I see another person, older.
Maybe wiser.
Maybe wiser. Thank you. Our friends say wiser, and other people say older. But it doesn't matter. My wife, I'm happy that I have. She's nice. She's so strong. She's day by day, she's stronger and nicer and younger. She has a lot of energy.
So you look older in the mirror, but she looks younger.
Yes. And you see, this is the same mirror.
Mr. President, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
You've got to go get back to the war.
Yeah, thank you so much.